Good afternoon, Trailblazers. Today is Thursday, November 21st, and it's an A-Day. You can do the mantra with me and then have your special thing.
Yeah.
Here we go. Mantra time. You belong.
I belong.
You matter.
I matter.
You are loved.
I am loved.
Always.
All right, boys and girls, I am here for Student of the Month. I know it seems early, but November is a short month. So starting off in kindergarten, our first student of the month comes from Mrs. Williams' class, and that is Annabelle Faulkner. From Mrs. Salazar's class, we have Charlie Johnson. And our overall student of the month for kindergarten comes from Mrs. Zachary's class, Isadora Dos Santos Barbosa. For first grade, from Ms. Long's class is Gemma Overton. From Mrs. Beltran's class is Sully Koski. And our overall student of the month for first grade is from Mrs. Petter's class, Santiago Bordas Allen. For second grade, from Mrs. Saunders' class, it is Sadie Bogart. From Ms. Stenson's class, it is Weston Booth.
This is what ad lib looks like, girls and boys. And she's got a computer in front of
it. It doesn't say the classroom teacher, just from memory.
Yeah, good job.
And from Mrs. McKay's class, our overall student of the month is Sophie Sennon. From third grade, from Ms. Cotton's class, is Jackson Buckner. From Ms. Stark's class, it is Scarlett Rodriguez-Zalea. And our overall student of the month for third grade comes from Mrs. Shambaugh's class, Glory Abel. Fourth and fifth grade are easier. It's only two classes.
Yeah, harder to mess those up.
Yes.
Good luck.
Okay, fourth grade, coming from Ms. Posh's class, is Maddie Bongi. And our overall fourth grade student of the month comes from Ms. Miller's class, Aylin Ockmoon. For fifth grade, coming from Mrs. Young's class is Grace Oltmans. And our overall student of the month comes from Mrs. Wagley's class, Callan Barton. So congratulations to all of our students of the month and all of our other students working hard.
Very good. Thank you, Mrs. Malcolm.
Thank you.
All right. We have no birthdays today, which is convenient because we also have no Mr. Fagan.
I know, right?
All right. Animal clue time. You going to do this one?
I will. Clue number one, it is a medium-sized bird with a large beak, just kidding, large head, sharp beak, and stocky body. The females are reddish-brown and the males are blue-gray and white. Clue number two, they eat fish, crayfish, frogs, and insects. Clue number three, they build nests out of the bones of their prey. And clue number four, they live in North and South America.
Did I give you this one?
You did.
And I don't know what it is.
I don't even remember. It's interesting though.
Tomorrow's lunch choices are lunch A, cheese pizza. Lunch B, bread and chicken sandwich. And lunch Y, yogurt and mini pancakes.
All right, when we return from Thanksgiving break, we will have a penny war. So get ready for some friendly competition and help our school raise funds in a super fun way. Each grade will have a jar, like so, to fill with coins and bills. Here's how it works. Pennies and bills add points to your grade level's total. Silver coins, nickels, dimes, and quarters, subtract points from other grades' jars.
Get another jar here.
All right.
So if this jar has 100 pennies in it,
yes,
and I have a quarter from another class, I'll put it in second grade, and now they subtract, and they only have 75 pennies.
Yep.
Wow. So yeah. You could go to other grades that have a lot of pennies.
You can. So you can focus on putting the pennies and dollar bills in your jar, and then if you want other grade levels to lose points,
silver.
You can put the silver in the other jars.
Silver takes away.
Pennies and bills.
Pennies and paper.
Pennies and paper, yes. And the goal is to add as many pennies and bills to your jar while sabotaging the other grades with the silver coins.
And what do we do with all this pennies and money at the end?
So every coin and bill counts, and all the money is going to go toward the PTO and fifth grade legacy.
There you go. Oh, you got it right there. I'm that living.
You were, but you got it. So take some time over Thanksgiving break to look for some spare coins around the house, maybe say, Grandma or Grandpa, we're having a penny war next week while you're eating turkey.
You should ask them.
Ask them. Don't take. Ask first.
Yes.
So let's show some spirit and make this a fundraiser to remember. And I did not mention there will be a prize for the grade level that has the
most points.
So the most points. So this will be out, in the lobby when you come into school every morning next week when we get back from break.
Very good.
All right, learning all along.
Growing strong. Nobody's pushing pause.
Uh-oh,
we're just gonna sit here like this.